Now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get this leg back in here. Okay. Let's see. Right leg right here. We're going to see how this thing goes. Right leg is right there. Anyway, that's where that's going to go. So we're going to put the right leg. This is going to fit. I know it is. First, we're going to cut lip slots for starters. Go ahead and go up toward the nose. Make sure you cut plenty of lip slot. You can always fill it in with clay. I put a couple of holes in the nose. I get the eyes rounded out. I could use a little clay in there or epoxy sculpt. Okay. Got a little clay and epoxy sculpt. We'll get the eyes. We're going to go ahead and make sure these fit. Okay. I'm going to use some epoxy sculpt because I want these eyes to set up kind of quick, I guess. Anyway, here we go. I'm going to go ahead and see what we got to do for our eyes here. Just go ahead and fill that in. Set your eye in there. Give it a little squeeze. What I do is I look from the top. Make sure your eyes are kind of level across there. Same depth, same eye sticking out. Same amount of eye. Take pieces of clay in your fingers and go ahead and make an upper and lower eyelid. A little muscle around there is what you want. We'll always be able to get rid of that or squeeze it out. But I want to be able to shape that a little bit. Anyway, and that's how you get a little eyebrow here. That's how she's going to look. And then when we get that on there, it'll be a little bit better. Now what we're going to do, I'm going to put this front leg in, the right front leg. We know this is the right one right here. We dorsal cut this. First things first, let's get some dry preservative on there. I use plenty of dry borax is what I use. Okay, now, one thing you want to do is get yourself a tool and force some of that borax down into the legs. Or when you have them turned right inside out, borax them. Put some down in there. That'll preserve that, dry it out for you. Get some more in there. Especially the back end. Now, I've got the tail I've got to do, and I've got both back legs, so. Go ahead and force that down into there with the screwdriver, anything. Just get that, get it down into the foot. You see how I'm just kind of pushing that down. I can feel it down in there. It kind of feels granular. Now what we got to do is we got to make sure we get some in the tail. We just go ahead and keep pushing that baby down in the tail. You get a little twist in your tail, that's okay. Okay, what you do is if you can't get it all the way down in there, just keep going, get yourself a wire. Okay, now just take your wire, skinny wire, push that, hold it up, make sure you push that all the way down in there. You can feel it going down in there. You can feel when you get to the end too. Push your wire, there you go. Now we're gonna need that wire for his tail later. See if we got this baby all coated. But the only glue I'll use on here is around his eyes and around his mouth as far as holding things in place, because the squirrel skin will tighten up pretty good. You don't have to worry about gluing it. Okay, now we got everything ready to go. We got our lips, we got everything here. Okay, we're gonna put this leg in. We know which one's the right leg. What you do is you just go ahead and get that in there, push it down in there. Get the foot up in there where it's supposed to be. Okay? Yeah, pretty darn good. Okay, now we're going to take this left one, do the same thing. Make sure we got a fairly good fit over here. We'll fill that in with clay along here after we get her in there. We'll get her all set and ready to go. Oh yeah, oh man, I'll tell you what, we're pretty darn good, folks. Okay, let's see, it's this one right here, we'll get this foot on here. Okay, that's the right foot. I'm gonna get that baby in there. We'll figure out which way it goes. It goes toward the flat part, in toward there, in toward the tree. So I've got it in the way I want it, right there. There we go. And what I'm doing, I'm pushing that down in here. Here, we got the paw in here. You can feel it. We're going to do the same with this side over here. There's a lot of different ways you can do this stuff. This is one of the better ones. Okay, what I'm going to do, this wire I got here, I'm going to go ahead and cut a piece of this off so I can mend this leg that we put in there. There's a good snipper right there. I'm gonna go ahead and put this piece of wire in here. I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bend in there. But I wanna hook that in there. Now, let me get a little clay here.
I'm gonna need
some taxidermy supply houses supply pretty good clay. Others charge you quite a bit. If I need it quick, I'll go to Hobby Lobby and get it. If I can wait a little while, I'll order it from some of the supply houses. What I'm gonna do, I know on the back ones I'm gonna need a little clay down in each one by the foot. So I put a little roll in. put it down in there. That way when I put that leg in there, it'll force that down in there, and I'll be able to mold that a little bit. It'll force that clay ahead of itself, and that way I can fill in these gaps in the feet there, or the ankles, I guess you call them. Anyway, this will be attached to the tree by a screw from the underside. Sometimes you have to put wires in, and you end up not getting so hot of a job done. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to put these back feet in first. Now, sometimes you might have to undercut your forms in these areas, get them fit tight, but this isn't going to even show, so we aren't even going to worry about that. We're going to get these feet in here. Okay. We got this. That's kind of a nice fit. Nice loose fit. You see how these feet are going to be. Okay. What we're going to do, I'm going to take that wire I had, and I'm going to make a couple of what I call just little wire pins, just to hold those into place for a little bit. I know about where I want them here. See that? This one here goes on this side. This goes on this side. Go ahead and grip them in your rugged cross. Okay. Just leave a little bit sticking out. And then take your clay. You can see where I needed to mold this on the top a little bit. Just put some in there and we'll mold that around there. Don't worry about the bottom side. That's going to be up against the tree. Just go ahead and make a nice transition here against this side and down into the armpit area here. That way. There we go. Now that's going to be nice. Now we'll do the same thing with this side right here. We're going to look and see where we're at here. And I'm going to take and stake that with that other pin right here. We're going to go ahead and do a little clay modeling around there so it looks good. Tell you what, we got such a good looking squirrel going. I use a kind of a heavy thread here, and what I do is I leave it doubled up when I sew on squirrels. I don't on birds, but on squirrels I do. And anyway, here we go. We're going to start sewing up the squirrel. Go ahead and use small stitches. 1/4-inch stitches on the squirrel look pretty good, I think, anyway. Some people might argue you need smaller than that, but I don't think so. And as long as it's my video, I might be right. But anyway, we'll try to get this where I can show you what I'm doing as I go along. One thing you don't want to do, you don't want to run that needle through your finger, because I can guarantee you that baby will hurt. You'd have been proud of me last week. I was making a jackalope. I drilled through the horn right into my fingers. the drill was running. And let me tell you one thing. A running drill hurts when it goes in your finger. I had to quit for the day on that one. That was a little intense. See this size needle here? That's not a very big needle, you know. What we're doing is we're just sewing up the back of this squirrel. We'll get him all taxied up after we get him sewed. We'll get him in the right position. Put in two or three stitches, then pull it tight. Now, you know, pull it tight. Snug it up, I should say, snug it up. And that way, that kind of helps sometimes if you're, like on thin skin game, sometimes you have to get more than one or two stitches. If you try to pull one stitch, it'll pull loose. But if you pull two or three stitches, it seems to work a lot better. I'll tell you what, a squirrel has a tough hide. I don't care what anybody says. Those son of a guns are tough. I know he doesn't look like much right now, folks, but he will. He looks kind of rough. Everything looks rough after you taxidermy him. Until they dry out, you do your final finishing. Sometimes people come in and want to see their mount, how it's going. And I really, you know, I hate to see that. But if they want to see it, it's their mount. You just got to explain to them, say, hey, it'll look different when it's done. You know, things are drying, they got pins in them, they got stuff like that. I mean, it's just, it just doesn't look too good. So, but that's all you can do, just tell them. Kind of hold the hair back out of the way. Hold the hair back a little bit. You can tell if you didn't get through the skin and you get through just some little soft tissue along the edge. Make sure you get through the skin. You can see here how I kind of hold that hair back from the edge right here and then press this way through there. Kind of come out at an angle so you go in a little bit back here and then come out close to the edge up there. And that'll pull that together pretty good and keep hair out of the way. You ever want to take your phone and toss it? No, if my wife wasn't home, I'd have to get up and answer that goddamn thing every time it rang. Getting pretty mad right about now, especially if you're right in the middle of skinning something or putting something together and you got that going. But anyway, we're making some time here now, but she'll be happy. She's a good kid. 11, 12 years old, likes to hunt and fish. Wants to be a taxidermist when she gets older. That's good. I like to see people get their kids outside and do things with them instead of letting a computer or a Wii game or whatever babysit them. Nothing can take the place of a parent. I don't think, anyway. No matter what. We have to give those kids the basic foundation to start with. You know, that's what I always told my daughters, we'll give them a good start in life. Get them to school, get them to college, get them a good start. And then they have to make it after that, you know. Well, you can help them out as much as you can, but sooner or later they're going to make it on their own. Anyway, we're going now. Now I'll show you what we do when we get down by the tail here. We're going to stick a wire in there. We'll know exactly what we're doing before we close her up, as they say in the operating room. I don't have anybody do the closing up for me. I gotta do it myself. But before we close her up, we'll get a wire in his tail. I could use a closer around here once in a while. Alright, here we go. What we're gonna do, we're gonna take our wire, put it down through the tail, thread it through there, all the way out the back, all the way till the end, till it comes out. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put a point on this end. Now what I'm going to do is right here where I've got this tail butt right here, I'm going to put this wire in right here. I'm going to stick it in there a ways because I really don't want it to come out too much. Now if I get it in there, when this thing dries, it isn't going anywhere. Okay, now take and cut the wire off here at the end of the tail. And there we go. We got our wire set. It's not complicated like I told you. This isn't brain surgery. But by God, I think a guy could become a surgeon after doing this for a while. I've had a hectic couple weeks here with deer. I mean, I just got swamped this year. And I didn't think I would. I thought it'd be a little bit slower with the economy the way it is. And evidently, hunters and fishermen can still afford to do what they do. Because this has been one of my better years. I can't figure it out. I've been trying to think about it a little bit. But I just don't know what the deal is. A lot of guys are laid off. A lot of people are laid off. But I'm having more of everything done this year. More small game. More deer. It's just one of those things that it's hard to figure out why. Anyway, we won't go. We won't wonder too much as long as we can keep earning a living doing it. That's one thing about taxidermy or any other part of the sporting industry or hunting and fishing industry. You get a chance to do something you like to do, people pay you. I mean, and it's got to do with the outdoors. I mean, you can't hardly beat that. I mean, that's what we think about all the time. How can I make a living doing what I'm doing, you know? And we'll go ahead and make sure we get a good knot there. We got that cut. We got that done. All right. Now, let's see what we got here. We got the leg here. We want to go ahead and pull this skin up. See how this foot is. We got that clay in there, and I'll make sure that I get that up in there where I can feel that. I want that foot up in there, like so. I want that right against there. I can feel these two pieces joining right there. Okay. We got these feet. Okay, we're gonna go over to this side, make sure that I can feel that one too. Well, that's pretty darn good. Anyway, our skin's a little bit loose, but that's all right. What we're gonna do, we're gonna get some pins, and we'll go around the eyes. Little straight pins. We're gonna do the mouth. I'm gonna get some super glue here, right here. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna see what we got here. We're gonna take a test run. We got his nose right here. We'll have to rebuild that nose. Now I know I got I got skin there. I got the nose here. You look at a squirrel's nose, it kinda goes like so. What I wanna do, and I wanna get this nose stuck right there. I wanna get these lips in here. You can see where the lips go in here. So, I'm gonna put a little glue on there. Okay. I don't wanna do it all at the same time. I'm gonna take a pin. I wanna get that on both sides. You see how we kinda put that together right there? Then we're gonna put a little bit of drop, put a little drop right under where his nose goes. And then we're just gonna go ahead and put that right there. See how that kinda held that right in there? That's gonna be that nose is gonna look alright, I guess. Now we just take a look and see what we got here for a bottom lip. So you gotta kinda look at everything, see where it all goes. Is if you can see this, I've got plenty of room to stuff these lips back in there. Okay? Go ahead and tuck this top one first, I guess. See how I just kind of folded that in there? And I'm going to do the same for this one right here. There we go. I'll put a little glue right up in here. When we fold that over, that'll catch that. And stick your pin in there and just put that baby in there. Just tuck it. And now go back and tuck your sides in. You might have to get something bigger than a pin. You see how we tidied up that mouth right there? That'll look good. Now what we're gonna do is stick some pins all the way around there. You saw how that mouth was tidied up really nice on there? Really, that closed up real good. Nose is nice. What we're going to do is we're going to stick pins in all the way around there. A lot of people don't like to do a lot of pins, but I do. Just put them in around the mouth. We're just going to go ahead and hold that into place while it dries. It'll dry out in a couple days. On your squirrels, you got to do sometimes the little details will stick out on you. So if you're not too, we'll get this in here. The glue's gonna hold it while it dries. Once it dries, it's locked into place. That's leather. It's not gonna move a lot. Okay. Okay, now the eyes. Let me get my thing here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna see what we got here. Clear it out around there with your pin. Go ahead and make just a little bit of a tear duct type deal. Tuck in your eye here at the bottom. Make a little eyelid, like so. Squirrel eyes, when you look at them. Now just go ahead and press that down with that epoxy sculpt foot. Or kind of what I call, make yourself an eyebrow right here. And kind of oval. Now you can put super glue or whatever you want. But what I do is I get that eyebrow made. And then I'll go ahead and shape that eye like so. Now I won't let this baby dry a day without me checking on it. I want to make sure these eyes, I'm gonna put in, pulling right in there to your tear duct is. But anyway, go ahead and clear that out like so. Get your bottom lid formed. I got a pin and mortar tear duct. I'm gonna get one in the back corner here. And then I'm gonna put one in right where you would on a deer here. I don't want that god darn thing to stay in there. Get it looking like a squirrel's eye. Get a reference photo out. There's a lot of squirrel pictures out there. Get them out. Take a look at them. There we go. Now, the ear here, we're going to end up putting a pin in here. See if we can find a pin here. That'll hold that up. Let me get a couple bigger pins, quilling pins, that kind of. And what you do is you just go ahead and feel where that ear should go. You can feel there's a register mark here on this form right here. The ear canal is right there. So I'm gonna put that ear right there. And clear out around your eye. Go ahead and make your eyelid or your eyebrow. Go ahead and make a little tear duct. Put a pin in that tear duct area. I do anyway. That kind of keeps things in one place right there. Bring this eyelid down. Bottom eyelid. If anything's in the way, just scrape it out of the way. An epoxy sculpt. Anyway. Just get that stuff around there where you should be. Go ahead and press down a little bit where that epoxy sculpt is. Pin in this back corner right here. That'll help me hold that in there. Now, this eyebrow. I'm going to put a pin in right here. I know I'm using a lot of pins, but that's what it is. And that'll hold that.
You look at both eyes from the front here.
I mean, you want to see about the same amount of eyeball, stuff like that. Just so they kind of look the same. Now we're going to go ahead, and when he's drying, just go ahead. Now you want to wait until he's almost dry. Once we get this baby up there for the next couple days, once we get her in position, we don't want to move it. Because your hair will start falling out. That's one thing about when you dry preserve, you gotta watch the hair. So anyway, we'll get this other one set up to go, the ear, and then we'll get him on, we'll get him where we're drying at least anyway. Now, we're just gonna dry him out a little bit. Get this foot here. Takes a little bit to dry him, but you get the tail dry. You can use your air compressors for this. Squirrels are a nice fun mount to do. They're not real difficult, they're just kind of... You can have a lot of fun doing them. If you ruin them, it's no big deal. You can go ahead and save the form, get another skin, and do it again. Makes for great practice if you're going to do it. If you want to try taxidermy and you want to get a good feel for it, this is it. Try a squirrel or a pheasant. You'll know whether you like it after that. Or a duck or a goose is a little bit too much for a beginner. A deer is way too much for a beginner to start. You can do it, and you might do a decent job, but it'll be hit and miss. Go ahead and rub the hair a little bit while you're drying it, and that'll break it up, the clump. Get the belly too. You want your hair as fluffy as you can get her. Like I say, a squirrel will dry up in a couple days. You just take a little tug on a little bit of hair, and if it isn't coming out, it's getting pretty dry. But you got to be real careful handling them after this stage. After we get this mounted up here, we won't touch it for a couple days. We don't want to pull any extra hair out. You can kind of see how that's starting to dry a little bit now. Go ahead and rub it a little bit. Just kind of breaks up those clumps of hair. It's starting to come around now. He's getting some. Let's get the neck area, because he's going to be having neck up, and let's do something different. Let's see about getting this guy up here on here.
Drilling a hole through here.
I'll show you what we're doing. I drill a pilot hole. Now I'm taking a spade bit. I'm going to come in from the back. That way I can run my screw through there. We can always fill this in. Okay. Now we'll go back to my driver. What we're going to do, we'll get a long screw. Okay, I'm going to put the squirrel on here. I want to see where I can put these feet. Everybody's feet will be on here. Okay. I'm going to put it right here. I'm going to screw right into the belly. I'm going to tighten that up a little bit right like. Okay, we got our squirrel hanging here. Okay. Take our feet, make sure that they're in a proper position. We're going to do the back feet first, okay? We'll make sure they're in a proper position here for what we want it to look like. I'm going to put them so they're holding on to this tree. Get me a good pin here and I'll be in good shape. Just go right on through and into your tree. Now when you come back in a day or so, these squirrel's toes dry in a hurry. What you want to do is you want to bend these toes around. We're going to get a close look right here. I'm going to bring it in real close. Here's his foot right here. We want to make sure that this foot, we got it set right here on his leg, right? So they kind of grab. Now, they're kind of, you got to spread them out and they'll kind of grab. And you do that every day until they're dry. You'll have to come out and move them. I'll turn this around and we'll see this other side too, what I did. You can see how I kind of, got these. What we'll do is just every day you got to come out and move them, just like so. I want that to look like he's hanging on to that. Okay? Now, you see where I put this foot right here? Now, you see how this one's hanging out here? We have got to do something with that. So, we want it to look natural. And I'll tell you what, if you've ever watched squirrels in the wild, they'll hang almost upside down sometimes. And have their feet just hanging. I've seen them do it. Anyway, we're going to take and put this one in here and hold that in there while it's drying. And we may have to come back and do something with that. We'll see. There we go. Okay, there we go. Now let's see if we got these paws spread like that. I mean, we'll come back every day. Make sure the ears are good. We'll look at those. We're going to go ahead and do some more drying on him. Now, if your shoulder doesn't look quite right there, we can go ahead and put a few more pins in there if it's pulling away from the body where we put that leg in there. That's okay. We can go ahead and put a few more pins in there if we have to. We'll see what it looks like tomorrow. Now, if you want to tighten up your skin a little bit on a squirrel, you can pull it down around the belly or just pull it up on the back a little bit.
And just put a pin in there to hold it.
Then it'll just put it in there to hold it till it's dry. Then I'll just tighten it up a little bit. You can do the same thing around here if you want to. You move that skin about anywhere you want. There we go.
I'll do later is this thing here is getting pretty dry. I'll come back and I'll hit it with an air hose when it's dry. And that'll break up all the little clumps of hair. I want to get the hair looking pretty good before it starts drying and setting. Because that's why I want it to, dry in the, location I put it now is where I want that hair to dry. In your animal when you're doing, when you're skinning it or whatever, you can still patch them at this point if you have to, but you should do it before you mount it up. But you can still patch them, just put a, go in underneath and just go ahead and do it. Use a curved needle. Now the ears here, this is one of those things you gotta watch too until they dry. You can put a little piece of cardboard in there, but you gotta make sure that it's bent. Let me show you what I mean. What you have to do is you have to make sure that thing is, you're gonna put the whole ear in there, so you gotta make sure that it's bent. You go ahead and put it on there, make sure it's bent. Then you can staple it or whatever you have to do. A little paper clip works good. Or you can do this here. You go ahead and cut your, get a good basic shape of your ear. And you just go ahead and put them in there. Bend them a little bit. And put them in there, follow the shape of the ear. Put one on the inside. Put one on the outside. Now you can take and put a little staple in there. Put a staple in each side. Go ahead and put a staple in each side of this. Okay, make sure it's bent when you staple it. I'm going to move this needle out, so this pin out, so I can get at this. Make sure that it's bent, otherwise you don't want it straight. Okay, now take your pin and put it back in there. Feel where your register hole is there. There you go. And now you got your ears set right there. Let's turn this a little bit. Let's pull this pin out. Let's bend these. It's bent. We'll bend the other one the same way. And what that does is that'll make a nice little cup on the ear. Okay, we're gonna put this one on the inside. Make sure, there we go, right there. Put this one on the outside. I'm gonna go ahead and staple one side. I'm gonna bend her, staple the other side. Okay, now we're gonna repin it. Find your hole for your ear right here. And then you can, if you want, you just keep an eye on these ears. Get down low and look at them. That way you can tell if they're about the same. Now the head should be a little fuzzy. We're still doing good here. We'll give it a little bit more and then we're gonna... get this head a little bit fluffy. If you can see this squirrel now, okay. Now we got this squirrel going as good as we want it, or as good as can be. You can see here on the eyes. Let's see if I can zoom this in a little bit. The eye is pretty holding its shape, pretty good. You use your T-pin here, and if it doesn't look like it's the way it should be, go ahead and move it. You gotta admit, that squirrel doesn't look too bad, does it? That's gonna be a nice looking squirrel. Anyway, we'll do some more work on him later. But this squirrel is about in what I call what he's gonna be looking like when he's done.
I'm gonna go eat lunch.
We're gonna have this guy ready to go. I'll show you on another squirrel down here what we did. We'll finish him up, and then this black one will be the same way. And we'll be ready to go.